protecting you from Brock Lesnar.
I love you, wise man.
I love you too, my tribal chief.
And I thank you for your honesty.
I thank you, my tribal chief.
And I thank you for 40 years of service to my family.
I love you, my tribal chief.
And you're fired.
Oh my God! Absolute betrayal by Paul Heyman in Roman Reigns' eyes.
No.
Paul, it's been 1 week since you were fired by Roman Reigns publicly.
Publicly. Publicly. You gotta get that little dig in there. Publicly.
Paul, I can assure you I'm not trying to get anything in. I'm trying to give you the opportunity to tell your side, talk about what happened.
What happened? What happened is I told the truth to Roman Reigns. And it was a truth he didn't want to hear publicly. What happened was because I told the truth, I got fired publicly. Smashed in the face publicly. Embarrassed. Humiliated in front of my peers in the entire world publicly. What happened was, I told Roman Reigns the truth, and I paid a price for it, publicly.
Well, do you now regret telling the truth?
No. Because my role as special counsel was to tell Roman Reigns these uncomfortable truths. My role as special counsel was not just to protect Roman Reigns as a personality, as an intellectual property, but as champion. When I came back from the ring, I tried to explain this to Roman Reigns, and all of my bags, all my notes, all my suits, all my belongings were tossed out of his locker room into the hallway. Like I was some frickin' rookie. But my role was to protect the championship. And make no mistake about it, Roman Reigns is the greatest universal champion of all time. But he needs to be protected from Brock Lesnar.
Well, Paul, now what? What's next for you?
Excuse me. Now, I go to NXT, I cherry pick a top talent, I start all over again. Not at this stage. I put every bit of my heart and my soul and my spirit into serving as the special counsel to the tribal chief, Roman Reigns, because I believe in Roman Reigns. Without that, maybe it's time for me to acknowledge my career is most likely